Every Scrivener project has a binder. It's an essential part of the interface. The binder is how you will typically organize and navigate around any given project. Think of it as a ring binder, holding all the documents you've created or imported for this project. Adding documents to the binder is as simple as clicking the plus symbol in the toolbar or at the bottom of the binder. You'll notice that you're immediately prompted to give the new document a name. For the sake of simplicity, we'll call this Chapter 1. If you don't have a name for this document yet, it can just remain untitled. But once you type some text in the editor, Scrivener will create a text preview in place of the document title, which can help to remind you how each chapter starts when you're browsing through your project later. You'll notice these words appear in italic, indicating that this isn't actually the document title, it's just showing you the first few words of the text. I'll create several more text documents here. You can also use the keyboard shortcut Command N to create a new document, or if the binder is in focus, just hit the return key. You'll notice that each time you create a new document, it also opens in the editor. Clicking a document in the binder will open that document in the editor, and this is one of the easiest ways to navigate around your project. Folders are also available to help organize your documents. To create a folder, we can click the Add Folder button, or use the keyboard shortcut Command Option N. We'll name this folder Part 1. Moving the documents we've already created into this folder is as simple as clicking and dragging items into the folder, the same way you would move files around in Finder. If you want to rearrange your documents, it can be done the same way, but a thin line appears indicating where the document will be moved to. You'll notice that when you're dragging a document directly over another document, it's actually possible to drop it there and have it indented beneath as a sub-document. Any document can act as a container, and you'll notice the binder icon changes to a stack of documents to indicate there are sub-documents here. If you want to avoid stacking documents like this when you're rearranging your binder, holding the Option key will limit you to only dropping the dragged item between other documents. There are a few other ways of moving and grouping binder items. Try selecting a binder item, holding Ctrl and Command, then using the arrow keys to move the item around. Note that this will only move the item around inside its containing folder. To move it outside of the folder or indent it as a subdocument of the item above, try using Ctrl Command and the left and right arrows respectively. These actions are all available from the Edit Move submenu as well. A quick way of grouping multiple documents is to select several documents and go to Documents, New Folder from Selection, or hit Command Option G. This creates a new folder and places the selected documents inside it. Clicking the triangle icon next to a folder or stack of documents will expand or collapse it, which makes it easier to navigate larger projects. Holding down the Option key while clicking on this triangle will also expand any subfolders. As you've already seen, text documents can essentially act as folders, and as we're about to see, folder items can also contain text. The only difference between a folder and a text document in Scrivener is the way they look and how they open by default in the editor. Folders open in group mode, displaying their contents as a continuous scroll if you're viewing in Scrivener's mode, or as a series of index cards if you're in corkboard mode, whereas text documents always show their text. But folders can have text associated with them too, and you can see this by clicking the button to switch off group modes in the toolbar. This will display a blank document unless your folder already has some text. When we enter text here, notice the binder icon for this folder changes to show a text icon in the corner. If you see this icon, it means the folder itself has text associated with it, not text documents inside it, although it may have text documents inside as well. You can even convert between folders and files by choosing Convert to File or Folder from the Control Click menu, or from Documents Convert to Folder or to File. By now you have probably noticed that a Scrivener project has three special folders labeled Draft, Research, and Trash. These are present in every Scrivener project. And since they perform important functions, they cannot be deleted or moved inside of other folders, although they can be reordered and renamed. In several of our own templates, for example, the Draft folder is renamed Manuscript, but it performs the same function either way. This is where you write your manuscript. The Draft folder can only contain folders and text documents, and typically contains all the text you want to appear in the finished product. We should note here that images cannot be dragged into the Draft folder, but they can be inserted into text documents, either by dragging the image file into the text, or by using the Insert Image from File menu option. If you want to refer to images while you're writing, but they don't appear in the text itself, they would typically go in the Research folder. Likewise, anything you don't want in your draft notes, web pages, PDF files and so forth, can go in the research folder by default. You can put them elsewhere in your binder, except for the draft folder, but the research folder helps to keep things organized. The trash folder, as the name suggests, is where deleted files are kept until you delete them permanently, which can be done at Project Empty Trash. If you have your own preferred way of organizing a project, you can create other folders anywhere you want, even on the root level of the binder where the three special folders live. You can even give them custom icons by selecting them in the binder and going to Documents, Change Icon, or by control-clicking on a binder item and selecting Change Icon from the contextual menu. That's all we'll cover in this video, although we'll explore some more functions of the binder in a separate video, and if you want a closer look at any of the other features of Scrivener, our other videos should be linked nearby. Thanks for watching, and happy writing!